Hello everyone, Spencer here with FSElite, and today we are reviewing this 3DSimMods Throttle Detents. This is intended to replicate the physical feel of throttle detents that you can find on the A320 and CRJ when using the Honeycomb Bravo. This is a 3D printed third-party add-on that is for sale on Etsy. It is not made by Honeycomb. I spent the past few days using this and want to share my thoughts. Let's find out if it's worth picking up. The stick arrives in a standard cardboard USPS box. Inside the box is the paperwork explaining how to set up the product, as well as the product itself protected by a bubble wrap packaging. Putting in the magnetic detents was a bit scary. Reminds me of putting in RAM in a computer for the first time. It takes quite a bit of force to put the grips into position. Once you get them in though, you slide the brackets down so that the bottom of it is in the thrust detent range. Putting on the brackets for the throttle levers was pretty easy. Just need to unscrew an Allen screw, attach it to the lever, and then tighten the screw again. Once you're done with that, you just put the throttle on like normal. Uninstalling the product is a bit easier. The detents came out without much effort, and the brackets you had to unscrew. A couple of things I want to note. The detents, it appears, were built to be very close to the width tolerance of the channel and caused a bit of rubbing. When I took it out of the channel, there were some light scratches and residue left over. Not a big deal considering that this area is going to be covered, but I'm sure it would annoy some people. Additionally, these parts do not fit into the commercial box that Honeycomb provides, so you'll need to store the throttle levers somewhere else, or unscrew the bracket every time. The setup process is probably about 2 minutes, so you'll have to decide if that time is worth it to put everything away. Now that we have it set up, looking at the setup, it looks great. Despite it being 3D printed, it doesn't look totally out of place on the Honeycomb Bravo module. I really like the printed lettering, low profile of the magnets, and the fact that the lever cover matches the Bravo's default lever covers. Its low profile design actually makes it so that you wouldn't even really notice that it is there. The whole value proposition of this product is that the user would feel the various throttle detents, and I can definitely feel them. When I'm flying the Airbus, I no longer have to fidget with the throttle to get it into the proper position. I can just feel the resistance and I know it's there. The detents on the left side did not work great right out of the box, as I was getting some collisions between the bracket and the cover. I think this is a design flaw, and the designer did not adequately consider tolerances on the part, and chamfering the bracket probably would have solved the problem. All of this being said though, I reached out after discovering this issue, and the supplier was incredibly gracious and told me how to fix it. I had to do some quick sanding down of the bracket, and I was back up and running pretty quickly. I want to give major credit to the customer service provided here, and I will note that he provided this customer service without the knowledge that this product would be reviewed by FSElite. Hopefully the designer makes a version 2 of this product and better accounts for this issue. Getting in the sim, the first step you have to take is calibration. In the box is a manual for how to calibrate the fly-by-wire A320neo. This was super easy to do, only took 2 or 3 minutes, and the values in the manual matched the detents advertised. In the sim, it worked pretty well. I did a demo takeoff, which you can see here on the screen. Moving the throttles forward, you feel a click and resistance at the detents. From speaking with a friend of mine who is a 320 pilot, this matches real life feeling. After takeoff, pulling back the throttle to the climb setting is very nice. There isn't any guesswork you have to do. You just pull back 2 clicks and you are done. So, should you get this? I think if you fly the Airbus or CRJ a lot, I would pick this up. It's $35, $42 with shipping, which isn't too bad for flight sim hardware. I think it really increases the joy I have using the Quadrant while flying those jets. And if you're an owner of the Honeycomb Bravo, I think it would for you too. I will note that the supplier does have a few different versions of this product, one that is specifically intended for the Bravo Airbus lever attachments at the same price, and a more advanced one that includes flap detents for $15 more, or the whole set for $20 more. You can decide for yourself which one is best for you. That will do it for this review. If you have any thoughts or questions, put them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe. Hit the bell to get notified for future videos. We'll see everyone next time.